Ladies and gentlemen, we're back live on Thunder. What a debut. We are stunned, shocked, disappointed. I don't think there's any question about that. That the world title belt is vacant. Sting does not have it. Hogan does not have it. And I'm sure in the days to come, we're going to have some sort of statement. I don't know if it's going to be a title match or a tournament or a round-robin affair, what it's going to be. But that combined with Sting, first time we have heard the man's voice. And I think what he said in a very few words, Brain, spoke volumes about the way we feel.
I wouldn't want to be in Hogan's shoes right now. I don't think I'd even want to be in JJ's shoes. Can you imagine what's going through the mind, through the body, through the soul of Sting right now? Oh.
Guys, you can view it if you'd like as the old glass being half filled or half empty. I mean, let's face it, 10 minutes ago, we really thought there was a very good chance James J. Dillon was going to come out here, take the championship belt away from Sting, and give it to Hollywood Hogan in the NWO. At least he didn't do that. At least the glass is half full.
Well, Lee, that's a very good point,
yeah.
And one we need to draw on. I think the fact the NWO is as much upset about this as we are, as Kevin Nash, with Hollywood Hogan with him, makes his way out.
Well, you talk about bad news and good news. The bad news is Sting does not have the title anymore. The good news is Hogan don't have it either.
NWO doesn't have it. Well, now it's a chance for Kevin Nash to really do some damage. I mean, Sting no longer has the world title, even though the NWO and Hollywood Hogan, they don't have it either. But if Nash defeats Diamond Dallas Page, WCW can lose the two major titles in a span of what? However long this match takes. And fans, I know we are desperately out of time here. We're getting close to the end of these 3 hours of our debut of Thunder, but I do understand we're going to go as long as it takes.
Right.
And isn't that the policy with us? You know it from TNT. I mean, when the Braves go extra innings, what do? We hang with the Braves, right? When the Hawks go into overtime, we hang with the Hawks. And by golly, we're in overtime in the debut of Thunder here on TBS.
Tony, this is TBS. TBS set the standard for professional wrestling. Of course we're going to bring it. We're going to bring the action.
You realize us three could be doing the weather and sports in the morning?
That's fine. That's fine.
I don't care. This is fun.
Kevin Nash, one of the biggest, most powerful men in our sport, back from a knee injury. This is his return match. It was supposed to be Starrcade. As you know, he did not arrive at Starrcade, did not show up. But we do understand he and the Giant finally have signed and will wrestle at Snickers Sold Out on January 24th, the Saturday night, 8 o'clock, the day before the Super Bowl. It's going to be a super weekend for pro wrestling and football fans. And now in his debut return match, we're going to see exactly how his knee is. And he's going against a man who can diamond cut anyone from anywhere.
We speak of injury so often, Tony. The observation that one has to make is that for the first time in some time, Diamond Dallas Page is not wearing the tape around his ribs. It was a time he might as well have come in with a sign around his neck saying, you know, hit me, I'm injured.
Down goes DDP, and you know, one thing about Kevin Nash is he is so methodical and so big, so powerful. And you're not going to find a man any more confident in his abilities than this man. DDP trying to get him over.
Oh, nice move.
Swinging neck breaker. DDP covers one, two, and did not get it.
And let's also say that the World Heavyweight Championship came to Diamond Dallas Page without controversy. A clean win over Curt Hennig right in the middle.
Great point, right, Brain?
Right. But look at this Nash. He's taking his time. He's stuck in Diamond Dallas. And Hogan's at ringside. What does that tell you? Could be a long night for DDP.
Well, it's always a long night for anyone battling the New World Order. And in the light of what James J. Dillon has done tonight, and I'm not talking about removing the title from Sting, holding the title up, making it vacant. I'm talking about the fines, the suspension has been levied. I don't think there is any question in anyone's mind WCW is very serious, but I think the suspensions, the fines, have kind of handcuffed WCW from retribution, from the payback, from the 18 months that we, and I say we because I'm as much a part of this as you are, Lee, and you are, I guess you are this week, Brain. You never know about you, but
I am.
We're all a part of WCW, and we feel it too. We've been handcuffed. This is the debut of Thunder, and this will go down. I mean, the opening, the debut of this brand new program, weekly live program, it's going to go down as the night that the title was held up. How do you ever forget this one?
Again, Tony, if it's going to be a zero-tolerance situation, if nothing is going to be tolerated from WCW, conversely, nothing tolerated from the NWO, maybe we can all live like that. However, it has to be justice applied equally.
Yeah, but there's no way that the outsiders, that the NWO will stand for justice. They do their own thing. That's been well-established over the last 18 months in a running lariat, pinned DDP into a neutral corner. Fans, so much going on. We're going to have more reaction to what happened tonight on WCW Saturday night, 6:05 Eastern Time, here on TBS.
And Hogan, once again, is at ringside.
Don't forget to join us for 2 hours there, as we are certainly...
Think of this. This is the first Thunder, the very first Thunder. Every Thursday, it can only get bigger and wilder.
Oh, and it might end right here. Side Salto, one, two, and Diamond Dallas.
Did he?
No.
Did not. He barely got out. There you see Randy Anderson saying, hey, it was an inch from my hand hitting the mat for the three count. And this one continues here. Wow. That's all I can say. Holy smokes, what a night.
What a debut.
And it started off hot.
It really did. I mean, from the, as the old cliche goes, the get-go.
Yep, right out of the gate.
And now Kevin Nash. Nash looking like he's not lost a step here, guys. Still as powerful, in command, as dominating as we've ever seen. Certainly one half of the outsiders. A member of the Wolfpack. A charter member of the New World Order formed right here in this venue. Almost 2 years ago.
Yep. Was it Bash on the Beach? And again, Tony, probably the most prophetic words you said in perhaps your entire broadcasting career. I won't ask you to repeat it tonight, but what you said about Hollywood Hulk Hogan really was indeed quite prophetic.
Well, he certainly has turned out to be the man that Brain always thought he would be and always thought he was.
It's a frightening thought, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And here's a man the Giant better watch out. He's 7 feet tall, this Kevin Nash. He's well over 300 pounds, and he's not a slouch. He's one tough customer. Giant, don't take him easy. This man can beat you.
You know, I need to bring up another point here before time slips away from us. There is no question here, guys, that we have seen tonight, in the face of all the talk that we have discussed, we are seeing unity within members of the NWO. They all came out with Hollywood Hogan, every one of them together, when JJ made his statement. So, are they falling apart? Are they having problems? I still think there may be some problems, but I think in the span of 3 days from Nitro Monday in Georgia Dome to tonight, they've patched up a lot.
Tony, every family has their squabbles. Maybe what we witnessed was just an NWO squabble. They just play it out on a much larger stage when they're on nationwide television.
Well, these are some high-tech, high-paid athletes. Everybody's got their own agenda, their own ego, and to get it to work together, somebody's got to be a leader. Hogan losing the championship, maybe everything just started to fall apart for them.
Kevin Nash seems to feel that he has it in hand here, and DDP, to me, looks like he may be on the verge of being out cold. Here's the big elbow. Oh, my goodness.
Man.
I don't think Diamond Dallas is going to get up, fans. One, two, and I'm wrong again, thankfully. Incredible. Diamond Dallas showing the heart, determination, and courage that has now been over the past few weeks the heart and soul of WCW athletes.
And notice this, he's not trying to get out of the ring to take a breather. He's trying to get on his feet so he can fight this big guy, Kevin Nash.
That's right, and now Nash back to the attack, a pickup. Right now, DDP!
Watch it!
He's trying the diamond cutter, and Hogan with a gut shot! Hogan with a gut shot! Fans, we've been told we can only show you to the end of the match, so we are desperately out of time. We're gonna keep it here as long as we can. A disqualification. DDP's gonna keep the U.S. belt. And now Hollywood, the Giant stalking to the ring. And he's got his eyes focused on Kevin Nash. As Nash and Hogan. Hogan lets Nash know what's going on. Fans, we are desperately out of time.
But we gotta see this.
Face to face. And I'm being told that we're running quickly out of time. About 20, 30 seconds left to go in this program is all we can go here.
Oh, and they're going in. Here they go. This is gonna be good.
We gotta go.
Hit him.
It's wild.
Hit him.
Choke slam him! Oh. Choke slam him! Let's go! Let's go!
There's Hogan!
Nail him!